In today's session, we are going to look at the last concept in your network theory of the transmission line, that is the S parameters we are talking about. That is the comparison between the different parameters or the matrices. This we are going to deal with today, and the relationship between the all remaining parameters which you have studied for low frequency network with S parameter. We are going to look at this. So while comparing the S matrix with Z and Y, the following characteristics are common between S, Y and Z matrices. The first one, the number of elements in these matrices are same. In the sense, all these matrices, they are all square matrices, okay, of the order N cross N. That is one similarity between these three matrices. And one more property which we have seen in a S parameters or in S matrix is symmetric property. If you remember, for a symmetric property is applicable for a reciprocal network. So for a reciprocal network, all these matrices S, Z and Y, they are symmetric. So Sij equals to Sji. If you take impedances, Zij is equal to Zji, Yij is equal to Yji. We have even proved these three. All three we have proved. If you remember, symmetric property we have proved, and these two initially as a small concept using Lorentz reciprocity theorem and the Poynting theorem, making use of those two, we have proved this. So this is the comparison. And S matrix, it relates the waves instead of voltage and current, simple terms which you use for low frequency networks, that is in case of Z and Y matrices. So there you use V and I. Here S matrix, it relates the waves, traveling waves, or you can take voltage or current. So traveling waves incident on the ports to those reflected waves, incident and reflected both. Okay. However, in Z and Y matrices, we take directly voltages and currents. This you might have done it even in your network theory subjects. Few problems also you might have solved for simple low frequency circuits. You might have found these matrices. Coming to the advantages, we have looked at few of the advantages of S matrix already while taking the introduction of this topic. Why we go for S matrix? There were some disadvantages with Z and Y, so only S parameters we went, because we cannot use these Z and Y matrices or these parameters for microwave frequencies. So using microwave measurement techniques, the frequency VSWR, that is the standing wave ratio, voltage standing wave ratio, power and the phase of the microwave signals, we can measure them easily. This is one of the advantage if you use S matrix for microwave frequencies. Okay, so even VSWR meter you get, okay, frequency meter you get, these things can be measured easily for microwave signals. The power relations of lossless microwave devices and network, they can be easily checked by using the unitary property. What do you mean by this? For a lossless network, if you just look at the derivation, let me just quickly show you that. I'm talking about this. Okay. It is for a lossless network. These power relations, input power must be equal to the total output power. This we can readily measure, we can just verify using the unitary property of S matrix. So this readily measurement of the lossless network, how the powers are equal, input is equal to output, this facility is not available in case of the remaining two matrices, Z and Y. However, using the unitary property of S matrix, you can have that measurement easily. The power relations of lossless devices and networks. Okay. Now, in case of Z and Y matrices, voltage and currents, they are the functions of complex impedance and admittance. So they are the functions of complex. So both real and imaginary term will come, and because they exist, you have both magnitude and the phase. Okay. When the reference planes are changed, when they are shifted, so whenever you work with the low frequency network, in that when you use Z and Y matrices, there are the complex impedance and admittances. Complex Z value and Y value, they are complex values. So hence both amplitude and phase do exist. Whenever the reference planes change, if it gets shifted, in case of Z and Y matrices, there is a change in both magnitude and phase, because both impedance and admittances are complex values. Because of that, agar plane change ho raha hai reference, to aapka magnitude and phase dono change hota hai. But in case of S matrix, we have seen one property, phase shift property. Jab plane, reference plane change hoga, then only phase of the matrix will change. E raised to J phi 1, E raised to J phi 2, if you remember. Only that phase will change. No magnitude change occur. That's one of the advantage. Hope you have got these listing of the properties, advantages. At the last, I have one more slide to just, you can share it. The following are the advantages. Same thing I've listed, I got this slide. So let me just read it out. The short and open circuits, they are difficult to achieve for wider range of frequencies. When you go for microwave frequencies, it is difficult to achieve open and short circuit. But with Z and Y, it is easy. At low frequencies, you find these values by using short and open circuit concept only. And also, this we have just now seen, unitary property, it will help a quick check of the power balance of lossless structures. So no such immediate check is possible with Z or Y. And the last one, as I told, it is defined for reference planes. Okay, in case of S matrix, we take the reference planes. But in case of remaining two low frequency networks, ports are pair of terminals. So whenever you change the reference planes, there will be a phase shift. Okay, phase gets shifted. But however, if you take Z and Y, because they are the complex values of Z and the impedances, both magnitude and phase will change. These are the advantages. Let me go to the relationship between the all the matrices. So relationship between Z, Y, ABCD parameters and S parameters. How we are going to deal with this relationship is, we will find out the relation. Let me write it here. We have got these three matrices or these three parameters and S parameter. Okay, this is new one. What we will do, we have the relationship between S and ABCD. The equations are available to you. Qualitative analysis is there, so no derivations. Directly, how the value of S parameters can be got through ABCD value. This we have with us. What we will do, we will formulate the relation between Z and ABCD. And also we will formulate relationship between Y and ABCD. Agar aapko Z and ABCD ka relationship pata hai, to you can find S parameters in turn, indirectly. Okay. Agar given question mein, just a numerical, aapko ABCD matrix diye hai. Okay. Assume you have a square matrix. Okay. Four numbers are there. ABCD matrix is given to you. You have the formula list directly. You can find they directly by using the formulae. But instead of giving ABCD matrix, if Z matrix is given to you, then how you find the S matrix is, first you should go for this conversion, Z to ABCD, and from ABCD to S, you know the formulae already. That is, I'll just show you what are the list of formulae. So there is a two time conversion. So one is Z to ABCD or Y to ABCD, and then from ABCD to S. So we will look into these two relations today, Z to ABCD and Y to ABCD. First, let me start with Z to ABCD, relationship between Z and ABCD matrices. So I have written here how the Z parameters are defined by the equations. V1, V2, LHS, RHS, you have Z11, I1 plus Z12, I2, Z21, I1 plus Z22, I2. How you can get this? You have a matrix form. V1, V2, this is the column matrix, is equal to, you have a square matrix, a Z matrix, and here you will get I1, I2. Okay. So with this, this is your Z11, Z12, Z21, Z22. So if you multiply, you will get these two equations. Similarly, for ABCD, these two are the equations. So once we have these equations with us, let us see how we can find our relation between Z and ABCD. First, what I will do, I will verify, I will just observe the four equations listed. I want the values of these coefficients ABCD in terms of Z. Okay, so if you observe, in the first equation you have V1, I1, I2. In the second equation you have V2, I1, I2. Compare here with 3 and 4. V1, V2, I2. Okay, for time being, I can't take this. You can see you have I1, V2, I2. Right? I1 you have, I1 is here also. I2 you have, I2 is here also. V2. Okay, so all the parameters are available in equation 4 and 2. So you can make use of this relation. So what I will do, observe the equation 4. Equation 4 has I1 as the LHS. So what I will do, I will take the equation 2 and I1 ko LHS mein le jao. I have done that from equation 2. LHS will be Z21 I1. Z21 I1 is equal to Z22 I2. Minus V2. This, if I take it to the LHS side, I will get this minus. This is your minus. This is your plus. Okay. If I just change these signs, if I make this positive, this will become positive, this will become negative. Okay. Now, what I will do, equation 4 mein jo relation hai, I1, V2, I2, I will try to get that. I1, V2, I2. So readjustment, I1 ko LHS mein rakke, ye jo Z21 hai, take it to the RHS. Wo denominator mein aa jayega. I have taken it separately. This is numbered as equation 5. Hope you understood till this, what we have done. We have first observed the four equations. After observing, we have found that equation 2 and equation 4 have common terms. So what I did, as equation 4 has I1 at the LHS, equation 2 may I1 ko bhi LHS mein le kya ho, you will get equation 5. After that, you can just compare equation 4 and 5. See, both LHS are I1. So you have V2 here, you have I2 here. So just compare the coefficients, you will get C and D directly. So comparing the equations 4 and 5, I got C as 1 by Z21 and D as, you have 2 times negative, okay, both are negative. So Z22 by Z21, Z22 by Z21, okay. So directly we got C and D. So C is in terms of Z matrix, Z value, and D is also in terms of Z. Now I have to find A and B. For that, what I will do, now you go for remaining two. I have just now worked with 2 and 4. What are remaining values? Equations are 1 and 2. Okay. Just check out what are the common things in equation 1 and 2. Both have V1 at the LHS. RHS, observe, you have I2 in both. Just the variable is I1 and V2. Okay, isko common mein lana hai. So what I will do, just now I have got I1 in equation 5. Okay, I have just now found I1 equation in equation 5, which has V2. So that's why I can change this. What I will do? Equation 1 ko leke, usme I1 ka value substitute kar do. Only I1. So if I do that, substituting the I1 value, which is in equation 5, in equation 1. So what you get? This is your equation 1 actually. Stake V1 is equal to Z11. I1 just now I have found V2 by Z21 minus Z22 by Z21 into I2. So just now what all I have got, I will substitute it as I1 plus Z12 I2. Okay. So I have got this equation. This is similar to now equation 3. Observe equation 3 mein kya kya hai? V1, V2, I2. Here also you have V1, V2, I2, but I2 two times hai. So I will club I2 terms together. Okay, it's a simple rearrangement. V1, I will just multiply. I will get V2 term and minus two terms are there for I2. So what I will do in the next step, you can see I have clubbed these I2 terms coefficients together and take I2 common. So now I can just compare equation 3, which is for A and B, with just now what we got as equation 6. Equation 3 and 6 I will compare. So ye jo V2 ka coefficient hai, observe, you have V2 here, you have I2 here, and you have V1. So equation 3 also has the same V1, V2, I2. So compare the coefficients. V2 ka jo coefficient hai, wo A hoga. I2 ka jo coefficient hai, that is B. So V2 ka jo coefficient hai, that is A, Z11 by Z21. And I2 ka jo coefficient hai, this complete bracket, this is your B. So now we have found the relation between Z matrix and the Z parameters and ABCD parameters. You can see all together collectively I can write. No, I have not written. I have just put it in the boxes. This is your C value I have got in terms of Z value, D in terms of Z, A in terms of Z, B in terms of Z. So what all we have done? Just quickly recall it. First thing, observe the equations, both these pair of equations, 1, 2, 3, and 4. If you observe, equation 2 and 4 are having similar terms. You have V2, I2. You have I1, I2, all. But they are haphazard. So I will just try to make all at one sides. Okay. So I will just take equation 2, usme main I1 ko lungi. I1 I will take it to the LHS. See, I am not changing equation 4. I am changing equation 2 because I want this pattern. ABCD is equal to something. Why ABCD is equal to? Because finally, when I want to go for S matrix, because as I told you, Z and Y, the relationship we are deriving is this. Z and Y with ABCD. Once I get ABCD values, then I can find S easily. So don't go in reverse way. Don't take this equation 4, change the equation 4 according to V. Don't do that. Because V2 yahan par bhi hai. Aap isko bhi le sakte ho. Don't do that. Because we want ABCDs at the LHS. ABCD is equal to. ABCD ka value aa gaya to S ka value easily aa jayega. That's why you take equation 2, rearrange it. I1 ko LHS mein le jao, you will get equation 5. After comparing equation 4 and 5, I will get C and D values directly. Then, whatever equation 5, which is I1, if you substitute that in equation 1, I will get a similar kind of equation. That is, I can compare that with this third equation. So, I will substitute that. Substituting 5 in 1, I will get a equation 6, which I can compare it with 3. So compare 3 and 6, I will get A and B directly. Okay? This is the relationship between Z and ABCD parameters. Similarly, I will take the relationship between Y and ABCD. I will follow the same steps. Only the equations will differ. See, this is the equation, pair of equations. We go for admittance matrices. These two equations are used to find the admittance parameters Y11, Y12, Y21, Y22. And this, as usual, we know it. It is for ABCD. Same thing. So what you can do, observe the equations carefully. LHS I1, I2, V1, V2. V1 you have. Okay. So you can observe, you have V1, V2, I2. Three values you have. Here, V1, V2, I2. Okay, so equation 8 and 9 I can compare, but some readjustment I have to make. Because equation 9 mein V1 LHS mein hai, but here it is at the RHS. I will take the equation 8 and I will rearrange it. Equation 8 I will take, I will rearrange this. How to rearrange? V1 ko LHS mein le jao. Okay, I have taken the equation as it is. And isme V1 ko left hand side mein le jao. This is equal to, okay, rearrange it, I2 minus this. Or V1 is equal to, ye jo coefficient hai, usko aap RHS mein denominator mein divide kar do. If you take it, you will get 1 by Y21 I2 minus Y22 by Y21 V2. I think now you can compare. V1 is equal to, observe the coefficients, this one and equation 9. Okay, V2 is first, I2 is next. But here I2 I have written first, V2 next. So just aap isko aage peeche kar do. Take V2 first and then I2 next. I have rearranged it. V1 is equal to V2 first and then I2 next. The sequence, because I want it in that sequence, A and B. So in equation 9, the sequence is V1 is at the LHS. If you observe the RHS, you have V2 term first. So I have taken V2 term first and I2 term next. Take the I2 term next. Now I can compare equation 9 and 11 directly. If you compare equation 9 and 11, A and B values I can get easily. Direct. Ye jo bhi hai, minus Y22 by Y21 is your A. And check B value. You have actually minus here, but you have plus here. So the value is negative. Minus 1 by Y21, which is B. So A and B values are known to us. Fine. Next is, I have to again observe the equation and I have to find C and D. For that, what I can do is, observe, we have just now found V1. We will substitute this in our equation. V1, because I have I1 here, I have I1 here. Okay, so here I have V2, I have V2. Just the change is this, V1 and I2. So I will take this equation 7. Isme jo bhi V1 hai, abhi jo humne find kiya hai V1, I will substitute that. Okay, I have taken the equation, that is V1 value, I will substitute in equation 7. So I1 is equal to, see what is the LHS in equation 7? It is I1 is equal to Y11 V1 plus Y12 V2. I1 is equal to Y11 V1. V1 just now what we have found here in equation 11, I will substitute, plus Y12 V2 as it is. So just rearrange it. You can observe how many values are there. I1 you have. Here also you have I1, LHS, RHS, you have V2 terms and I2. Observe, you have V2 term and I2. So what I will do? I1 is equal to, just expand it. I1, if I club these two, y12 minus this complete bracket term, y12 minus. Okay, so I have clubbed v2 coefficients and v2 is taken common. Then i2, I have got one equation. What then I can compare this with this equation. Sorry, I was comparing it with this. I have to compare here. Okay, here i1. You have i1, v2, i2. i1, v2, i2. Fine. So now I can just compare the coefficients. i1, v2, i2. So this is your C and this is your D. If you compare, C is this complete bracket and D is this value. So in this way, whatever I have put it in the boxes, these are the relation between A, B, C, D and Y values. A, B, similarly, C and D. So A, B, C, D values we have got in terms of Y. So what we did, we have got the relationship between Z and A, B, C, D in the first case. Then we have Y and A, B, C, D also just now in the second case. And finally, what is the target? We want S parameter values, that is S11, S12, S21, S22. I'm talking about a two-port network, okay? Simple two-port network. So how to find this? I want a relationship between A, B, C, D and S. If I know this, even if in the question Z and Y matrices are given to you, you can find S matrix indirectly. How? Convert Z or Y, whatever is given to you, into A, B, C, D. After this conversion, take one more conversion to S. Now I have to know what is the relationship between A, B, C, D and S matrix. Okay, it's here. The S parameters are related to A, B, C, D parameters as follows. S11 is equal to, they are important relations. You need to remember these relations. You don't have any proof for this. Even though the first two relations which we just now derived, no need to by heart the values A equals to, C equals to, B equals to. Just how to derive the values, just to know the procedure. That is enough. It will take hardly 2 minutes to get the values. What is there in it? Four equations we list. We just observe. Substitute one over the other, compare and get the values. So don't by heart the values, the relations between Z and ABCD, Y and ABCD. Just remember the procedure. But here, relation between ABCD and S, you need to remember these values. S11, S12, S21, S22, all the denominator values are same. All are having a ratio. You can see the denominator is same for all. A minus B plus C minus D. It is same. For every parameter, it is same. Okay. A minus B plus D plus C minus D. However, the numerator is different. For S11, it is A minus B minus C plus D. This is for S11. For S12, it is minus 2 times AD plus BC. For S21, it is simply 2. And for S22, all A, B, C, D are negative. Minus A, minus B, minus C, minus D. So, A easiness kya hai? Denominator is the same for all. So, A minus B plus D minus D. Okay. So, if you remember these, and if you know the procedure how to get the relationship between ABCD and Z and Y, you can find the values easily. Now, there are two possibilities of the question. First type, they will give you ABCD matrix. Okay, I am writing here ABCD. It may be 1, 2, 3, 4 or any number. Okay. If this is given to you, find the S matrix. How will you find? You can directly use these formulae. Because these values are in terms of A, B, C, D. So you can compare this matrix, given matrix, and get the ABCD values. Substitute in each equation, get the yes matrix parameters. Okay, so this is easier. Second value, second possibility of the question is they will give you either Z or Y. Okay, so there are two possibilities. Either they will give you Z matrix or Y matrix, and they will ask you to find yes matrix. For in that case, agar aapko Z matrix diya hai, what you will do? First relationship which we derived just now, we will go through this. In this, we have got the relation between Z and ABCD. So Z matrix is given to you. You know what are these values directly from the given matrix table. Jo aapko matrix dete hain, this is the input data. You can find ABCD. ABCD directly by using the equations. Once you get these equations, ABCD ke values aa gaye. After that, in turn, go for substitution of ABCD here in these yes values. You will get the yes parameters. Okay, so two times conversion is required. If in the second possibility, either Z matrix is given to you or Y matrix is given to you. So this is how we get the relationship between Z, Y, ABCD, and yes parameters. Okay, let us just quickly recall what we did in today's session. We have seen some of the comparison, what is common in all these parameters or the matrices which we have studied, and then some of the advantages of yes matrix over the low frequency matrix, that is Z and Y. Some advantages we have seen. Then in the relationship, now one important thing is in relationship derivation, it is important to remember these equations. Okay, because this is the base. Agar yahi par wrong ho gaya to the complete value will go wrong. It is very important to write the equation 1 2 3 4 properly. What we did here, taking these four equations by observation, we took equation 2 and 4 are similar. So in this equation 2, I have got I1 equation. After that, I have compared this equation with your equation 4. I got C and D. Similarly, in equation 1, I have substituted for I1, kyunki equation 5 mein humne I1 hi find kiya hai. So I1 ko substitute karke, whatever equation we get, we will compare that with equation 3. Substituting, after substitution, I will compare this with equation 3. I will get A and B. Similarly, going to one more relationship, 7, 8, 9, 10. By observation, what I will do? I will take the equation 8. Okay. Equation 8, you have equation 8 here. From this equation 8, I will rearrange the terms. I2 is equal to, I will rearrange it so that it will look like equation 9. V1 should be on the LHS. After that, I will compare directly equation 9 and 11. So 9 and 11 comparison, I will get A and B. And jo bhi V1 humne find kiya hai equation 11 mein, isko aap another equation mein dal do. That is equation 7. Put 11 in equation 7. I will get one more equation that can compare and get the value of C and D. And finally, these yes parameter relations, the relationship between yes parameters and ABCD parameters, I have listed these four formulae. Important, you need to remember these formulae. The easiness is all denominators are same. A minus B plus C minus D. For all these S11, S12, S21, S22, denominator is same. Just the numerator is different. So if you remember these formulae, you can easily solve numerical. Okay. Hope it is clear to you. Whatever in today's session we have covered, the comparison, the advantages, and the relationship between the different parameters. Hope you have understood this. Any doubts in this, you can ask me.